Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful typographic photographic poster that you can apply to any subject you like. I provided this photo of the ancient ruins of Machu Picchu in Peru, as well as the links to the fonts I'm using. Feel free to use any font, photo, and colors you like using the same steps I'll be using in this video. Open your horizontal type tool and click near the top of the photo. Open the type picker and pick a font. This poster design is best with text that's all caps. Type out your text and drag your cursor over it to highlight it. Place your cursor over the size icon. And when it changes into a scrubby slider, click and hold as you drag it to the right until your text is close to the right and left edge of your document. To reposition it, place your cursor to the right of the text and drag it near the top of your document. To adjust the space between all your characters, called tracking, press and hold Alt or Option plus the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. Then resize it with a scrubby slider. Open your Move tool and drag it so the text is approximately the same distance to the top and sides of the document. Control-click or Command-click the text box to select your text shape. Press Z on your keyboard to open the Zoom tool and drag it over the lower section of your text to zoom into it. To reposition it, press and hold the space bar as you drag it, then release. Open the Rectangular Marquee tool and click the Intersect With icon. Rather than telling you what it does, I'll show you. Drag the tool over your text. When you release the tool, the selections that remain are parts of the text that were inside the shape that you dragged over. Go to Select and Transform Selection. We'll fit our entire poster back onto our canvas by pressing Ctrl or Command 0. Place your cursor on the transform's bottom middle anchor point and press and hold the Shift key as you drag it below the bottom of your document. Then release and press Enter or Return. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. In this layer, we'll fill the selection with black. First, let's check our foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. If they're inverted, press X. Since black is our foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Repeat these steps for each character. Ctrl or Command click the text layer to select its shape. Open the Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a rectangular shape over the text that you want to extend down to the bottom of the document. Go to Select and Transform Selection. Go to the bottom middle anchor point and press and hold the Shift key as you drag the Transform's bounding box down. To fit the poster onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Drag the Transform's bounding box below the document. Release, and press Enter or Return. Fill it with black, and deselect it. Control or Command click the top layer to select the shapes, and press Control or Command plus Shift on the text below it to add it to the overall selection. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. Make a new layer. In this layer, we'll fill the selection with white. And since our background color is white, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Then deselect it. Click the lock icon next to the background to unlock it. We'll place it just below the top layer by pressing Ctrl and the right bracket key twice. If you want to add more text to your poster, make the top layer active and make a new layer above it. open your vertical or horizontal type tool, and type picker. Click on your document. We'll adjust its size by either using the scrubby slider over the size icon, or you can type it in. Type out your text. If you want to adjust the space between two characters, known as kerning, click between those characters and press and hold Alt or Option as you click the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. I'll click the top alignment icon. Double-click the text box to make the text active, and click the color box. When the color picker opens, click a color of your photo to use that color for your text. Open your Move tool and position it to your liking. If you want to resize it, double-click the text layer and drag the size icon with your scrubby slider. Then click the check mark to accept it. Lastly, we'll add a border at the bottom of our poster. Make the text shape above the photo active and open the rectangular marquee tool. Drag the tool over the bottom of your poster, making its height approximately the same distance as the borders on the sides. Fill it with the same color and deselect it. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.